Today's sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, and Heinz Field. Tonight we move on to week two of the preseason, and we've got a good matchup here between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Now it's Barner. Oh, spinning away. And there's a flag on the field.
Illegal block in the back. Return team. Automatic first down.
Two receivers left, one to the right. Now a play fake here on first down. He's got time. And incomplete to open things up.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Wentz will try again on second down. Pressure comes and the Steelers take him down. The former Buckeye, Cameron Hayward. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Well, there was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Crowd getting in it a bit already. Here's an early 3rd and 10.
The Steelers insert their nickel defense on 3rd down.
Yeah, they add a DB. Now flags come in here. Look like one of the Eagles might have moved.
Start offense.
Crowd getting in it a bit already. Here's an early 3rd and 10. And some secondary help here for the defense and the nickel on 3rd and long. To throw, it's Wentz. And incomplete on the deep ball. Jordan Matthews, the one he was looking for. And that's going to bring up a 4th down. So on 4th down, here's the veteran left-footed punter Donnie Jones to kick it away.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
This is taken at the 23. Look at the spin.
Balance.
A very good return that time. 18 yards. And the Steelers will go on offense here, 1st and 10. They come up with one running back. That's Bell. They go play action here on 1st down. And there's a flag on the play. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant.
Holding offense.
Shake down.
Still 1st down.
Now it's Roethlisberger. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe.
Brandon, when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach and talked about how they wanted to begin this game offensively, they talked about their script, didn't they? 10 to 15 plays, the first 10 to 15 they had on their script. Nowhere on the script was there throwing an interception, I have to believe.
Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. 3 and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at the play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Now let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit.
Sometimes
better.
It's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
All right, here we go. Green 39!
On 2nd down, Ryan Matthews. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
For a guy who went to college as a quarterback, Ryan Matthews has turned into quite the power runner. If he can only stay healthy, But his numbers would be huge, I think.
His numbers so far, two times over 1,000 yards with the Chargers, 5 years there, now in his second year with the Eagles. And I give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and six.
In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Now a handoff here to his running back. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
On every snap, the defense is trying to establish who they are. But on third and short, that's really when you put it out there and tell people who you are. And that's exactly what they did. For the offense, they're looking at their offensive line and saying, guys, where are you? We need you on those plays.
And Sturgis able to knock it through. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with three.
And that should be the goal for an offense, finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. And an electric scamper there from the second round pick in 2013 out of Michigan State.
And how about the way he's remade his body in the NFL? You remember back in Michigan State, big, thick, bruising runner. Yeah, he had some speed, he had some agility, but now he's slimmed down and he's gotten even quicker, which has led to more runs like the one we just saw there.
Holding offense. Still first down.
So the penalty by the offense, and now they face a first and 15. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Out left side here to Bryant. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be a second down.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you just put the ball on it and then let him run.
He's got some space. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A really nice gain of 25 yards. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. But don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
And he did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helps back in high school. Again, it's Bell. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
I go all the way back to college with Le'Veon Bell, one of the better body transformations I've seen, from a big, thick power back to the guy we see now who can do everything.
And 2 years ago, of course, last year the injury, but 2 years ago over 1,300 yards. I think they think he can top that this year.
I don't think there's any question about it.
18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. They'll try and run it in with Bell. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell taking it in. And the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. I think the Steeler fans are happy to have Le'Veon Bell back in the end zone after that ACL injury last year.
No doubt about it. You know who else is really happy? The big guys up front, his offensive line. Because when you have a back like Le'Veon Bell that's piling up yardage, guess who else gets credit? The guys up front creating space. They need that guy to validate what they do up front, and he validates it in a big way. Love what he's done since leaving Michigan State and really taking the NFL by storm.
On the return now, it's Josh Huff. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. They begin the drive with Ryan Matthews. And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two. They've got it second and 10 to start things out. It's the backup, Bradford. Finds his target, Chris Givens. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. So they go out of the gun, trying to delay it on the draw, but nothing there.
Yeah, good play by the defense there. They sniffed it out and made sure there were no gaps for him to run. If you're the offense, though, you have to think to yourself, maybe I go play action down the road.
Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker, maybe a
touchdown, Philadelphia. Wendell Smallwood with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Eagles have retaken the lead. And that moment we just saw, always so special for any rookie, the first touchdown of his career.
And there's nothing like anticipation, is there? You know he's been dreaming about it, thinking about it. It's been a part of every bit of his being. And finally, it gets done. He's got to feel great right now.
Fairly short kick, taken at the 14 here. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he's brought down 18 yards on the pickup there. And it's good enough for a Pittsburgh first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence. Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Doug Martin, his second touchdown on the season. And the Steelers have once again taken the lead. extra point now by Boswell. And that makes it 14-10. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, we gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. First and 15 here behind the chains. Graham slotted out to the left. Working out of the gun, Bradford. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And hard running's gonna get him over the 40 to the 42. 5 yards will get him back to the original line of scrimmage, but now they're looking at 3rd and 10. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on 2nd down. On 3rd down, Bradford, it's complete. This is Brent Salah, and he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Now Moore. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
I love it. See if they dial it up this drive. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down.
You know what the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
But you're going to tell me. Good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first, it's good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the 2nd down incompletion. 3rd down, it's Doug Martin. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a 4th down. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. All right, so the timeout over, and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. And he gets this away, angled for the sideline with a lot behind it. Wow. That'll be out of bounds, and how good was that? They'll say the 3-yard line. That's where they spot it. Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. And that run there does nothing but juice up the guys who are moving the football. I mean, if you're an offensive lineman, people running it, actually the guy calling plays, you're almost jumping up and down in jubilation, aren't you?
Yeah, now you've got options on second down.
And big-time options. You might want to think about play action and try and get something cheap right here over the top.
Play fake here on first down. He sets to fire deep. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And this is a guy straight out of college. They're not going to try to groom for a year or two. They want him to produce right away.
That's why they took him in the first round. They expect him to be a starter right away and a future all-pro. So they don't have any time to wait for him to come along. They want him to play right now to help this team.
Really, it's a solid draft class from a year ago. They were able to address some key weak spots on their team and fill in some holes.
And they were able to identify the players they wanted early in the process. Got a little bit of luck, as some guys may have fallen to them. But for the most part, knew their philosophy and stuck to it.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Here's Bradford, looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Chris Gibbons was the intended target, and that'll make it second and 10.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. A play fake. Bradford. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's a first-round pick, Artie Burns. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Sammy Coates, the intended target there. And that'll make it second and 10.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it, trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Surveying the field. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Marcus Wheaton was the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up fourth down. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but it was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four. Moore now. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. A surprising move to go for it, predictably, at least somewhat predictably. It doesn't pay off, and the Eagles' defense able to hold. Though certainly not the way that they were hoping that possession would end, failing to convert on four.
And now they've got to make sure that they keep their poise, they keep their confidence. Just because it didn't work once doesn't mean if they get that same situation later that they shouldn't go for it again. The defense feels great, but the offense, they can't be despondent.
Fresh set of downs here.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. In the slot on the right is Graham. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Throwing again, Bradford on second and 10. And he comes back with one complete. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. So that would have been something from that distance, but to no avail. Comes up empty as we have reached the intermission. As we'll send you Dendo as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? And Larry apparently very brief in his report. Thanks anyway, my man, as we're already set for action. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. It's Marcus Wheaton now to return it. Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
And he's going to wind up bringing this one inside the 45-yard line.
Well, this has been a close game throughout, but that return can help them gain the separation that they've been seeking throughout the game.
The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. They'll set up to throw, and this is caught at the 8. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it, because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
It's a gain of 5, and that'll make it second and goal. Throw again. And he's in for 6 and a Steeler touchdown. Doug Martin, his second touchdown of the game, his 3rd on the year. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. So the second time tonight, he has hit the end zone, Charles.
Some people just have a natural nose for the end zone, and he's exhibiting that here in this game. Big time job, and of course, he's got to pat the backs of the offensive line.
Yeah, they can't be lost in the shuffle. They're vital. It's good, and it's 21-10. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know, at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
And all the way down to the 17-yard line. A big play there for Philly. 48 yards. I know it's just the preseason, but a lot of guys out here trying to prove something. I think he just opened some eyes with that carry.
And every year during the preseason, don't we see guys emerge that we didn't hear about before or hadn't counted on that go on to have excellent seasons and careers? Let's just go ahead and go back through that play with his eyes, because he's got to read his keys. Runner pass right off the top. You're probably going to read an offensive lineman to see if he sets up in pass protection, if he fires out for a running play. The next thing is you're going to check and see what the back's going to do, and if he ends up with the football, okay, now you got to check and see. Does an offensive lineman come downfield and try and block you? Are you going to try to elude him? Are you going to take him on and hold your spot? What are you going to do? In this case, didn't have to do any of that. Saw all of his keys, saw the play in front of him, and ran clean to the ball carrier and finished off the play.
He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Kenjon Barner, his second touchdown on the season. There the Eagles are back within a score. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
This is taken near the 13. Spinning past him. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they usually know it as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage. That's another nice run, and I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open. The other coaches said, you know something?
And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here.
And that's why defenders are often frustrated offensive guys. Actually made the catch, looked good doing it, but couldn't get his feet down in order to finish off the takeaway.
Holding offense. Still second down.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Call it a gain of 5. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. And he's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL. Being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. And now they're in the hurry up. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a...
Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. dangerous wide receiver with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. Here's the Steelers' kick team as they'll boot this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still got to fire out and smack the guy opposite them.
And the pressure gets to Bradford, and down he goes. Stephon Tuitt, the former Notre Dame man, in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
He lost. Back now in Pittsburgh. It's the Eagles behind but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. Third and long for Bradford. And that's complete to Huff. And he's brought down after a good gain. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Bradford to throw it. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. And not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it. And he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. So still a full 10 yards to go here for the offense on third down.
There we go now. 3, 39.
On third down, Bradford. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Slips past him.
Where'd he go?
And he's brought down after a good game. Give him 30 yards there.
What really hurts defenses on screen passes is that they eat up one of their levels right away. Because you know most defenses, 3 levels, D-line, linebacker, secondary. But on a screen pass, you're inviting the defensive line to get past them, and then you throw the ball over their heads, and now there's just 2 levels left to try and stop big guys out in front of a guy running with the football. We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. And that run, that was what we call a first level run.
Now a hit and the ball comes out. Bradford's lost it. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back, but it will be a loss on the play.
Well, that was a big oops right there. But how about his ability to correct it? Loses the football, able to get it back himself.
Yeah, bounced right back on it, keeps possession. Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved.
Offense.
Two receivers left, one to the right. Bradford from the gun on third down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
Yeah. The Steelers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
And he's brought down after a good game. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. More now. And this one caught by Coates. And he's brought down. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this point. You just go ahead and play.
Brought in by Coates. And he's brought down. Give him 13 on the pickup there. And it'll give the Steelers a first down. So here we go, first and 10 now. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
It's a gain of 7, and it's a second down. One man in the backfield, that's Martin. On play action, they'll throw. Flushed out right. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it and run time, and he picks up a first down.
Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now Moore. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to...
And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So backed up to the 6 now. Third and goal. So an extra defensive back on the field. They need a stop here on third and goal. They'll look to throw here. That's caught at the 1. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers field goal try. Less than an extra point attempt here. This is an 18-yarder. And Boswell's kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So they settle for just the 3 there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But 3 does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. And now the Eagles offense back out onto the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Bradford. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Philadelphia. T.J. Graham, 61 yards. And the Eagles make some inroads here on that deficit.
And they put it in the end zone, which was job 1. Now they have to convert. And then it's decision time, isn't it?
Yeah, this is what all teams go through. You look at the clock, you're inside 2 minutes, look at your timeouts, make that onside kick decision.
Yeah, how do you feel about your defense, where you are in terms of the scoreboard and the time left on the clock, as you noted? So many things to go through.
Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Back to the ground. This time it's Martin. Cuts it out to the sideline. And he's brought down after a good game. 23 yards on the play.
You got to feel a little bit for the defense there. They've done a terrific job all day long holding this guy in check. But that might have been the run to break things out for him, maybe turn things around. Now he's going to have some confidence, and maybe he'll get to his normal yardage.
And the knee is taken for the Steelers out of the victory formation. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it. And you know, every win is sweet, and I'm sure everybody enjoys a huge victory, but sometimes only winning by one score, two scores, a field goal, that can feel pretty satisfying too.
Without a doubt, because now you know that your team responds in critical pressure-packed situations. As a coach, as an organization, that makes you feel awfully good.